sculpting process. First of all, it's longitudinal section. You will draw elongated or cylindrical muscle fibers here. Just draw the boundary as base. You don't have to draw them very thick. But they should be of proper size. Again, put some color inside and draw the parallel lines within it, showing that these are the myofibrils. Now you will draw 3 or 4 muscle fibers, because muscle fibers, they are in the form of groups or fascicles. So this is one fascicle which is horizontal in direction, and one I have drawn in the vertical direction here. So you can draw both here, showing that these are the fascicles, one fascicle and the other fascicles. Now this is sarcolemma, this is sarcolemma. Beneath sarcolemma you will draw ovoid nuclei, and these nuclei, they are multiple and just beneath sarcolemma. Within these parallel lines are of myofibrils. Similarly, you can just give light shade in the background and then draw lines over it for the myofibrils. And similarly, you can draw again over nuclei at the periphery. In between these, you can label it as endomycium. This portion is for endomycium. And this is one fascicle. Similarly, you can draw an outline here, fill it up with myofibrils, and then with the now, for the skeletal muscle fiber in high power, you will just draw one muscle fiber, because it is understood when you show it separately in this high power diagram that all these muscle fibers, they show cross triations, but usually the power of 10x which we show you the slide really does not show these cross triations. When you put this slide in high power, you are able to see these cross striations showing darker A bands. So these are the darker A bands, and between these, this white portion, light portion, is the I band. And you will draw this diagram complete like this, and you will draw them at regular intervals. Do not draw it like this, please do not make these striations like this. Give proper distance to these, and at proper regular distance these striations should be there, but they should not be like this. Now for the transverse section, you will again draw outer less connective tissue for the epimysium. Although in the slide this epimysium is not apparent, but just to give you an idea that the muscle is covered by dense connective tissue, that is epimysium. That inside, yeah, you can draw these fascicles, which are separated from each other by perimysium. So this is the perimysium, and within each bundle of fascicle, this is one fascicle, another, and within each fascicle, there are the cut sections of these muscle fibers. So each muscle fibers transverse section is like this. You will draw it in the form of a block here, and in the center you will see these lines like in the form of these dots, which are the myofibrils, and the nuclei, they are ovoid and they are present at the periphery. You can see 1, 2, or 3 nuclei within a cut section of skeletal muscle fibers. But draw these transverse sections close to each other, leave very small space between these for the endomycium, but do not draw them at such a far distance from each other. Do not leave too much space here. Okay, just draw them close to each other and just put up these myofibers inside and nuclei at the periphery. And the epimysium and perimysium, you can draw blood vessels also, and the label is epimysium, this is perimysium, and in between these muscle fibers is the endomysium.